Good morning, all. Welcome to our Youth Sunday service. Before we begin, on the count of three, turn to those around you and say, "It is so lovely to see you here today." One, two, three. Awesome, thanks. May those who are visiting today please stand so we can give you a warm Ebenezer welcome. All right, looks like the visitors are taking a break today. That's okay. Let us all remember that we are in our Lent season, and in this season we invite you to journey with us as we reflect on the sacrifices that Christ made for us. Each week, a new Lenten symbol will be added to our display. Our attention today is drawn to the disparity of colors with the drab brown sackcloth against the rich color of purple. Let us remember to keep each other in prayer, especially those listed in the bulletin. We express our sincerest appreciation and gratitude to all of those persons who assisted with our Thanksgiving dinner and rededication service last Sunday. Can we just give a round of applause for all of those who did assist? Now, on to birthdays, one of my favorite things to celebrate. My birthday shout-outs, our birthday shout-outs, goes to Megan Martin, Randy Knowles, Pandora Monroe, Patrick Miller, Krusty Morris, Elmina Bethel, Vivica Thordeson, Alberta Edgecombe, Sierra Bryce, Patricia Smith, and Inger Austin, and all of those who may not have been mentioned but are celebrating birthdays this week. Now, let us sing Happy Birthday. On the last Sunday of each month, Ebenezer provides a meal for the Naomi Christie Home residents. If you're interested in assisting, please contact Ms. Ann Lever. Her contacts are printed in your bulletin. Lastly, our Bible study will begin this Tuesday, February 20th. Now, let us lift our voices by singing hymn number 313, followed by the first scripture reading, which will be done by Ms. Kathleen Pinder.
Thank you. The first scripture lesson is taken from Matthew 22, verse 34 to 38. But not the Pharisees. When they heard that he had routed the Sadducees, with his reply, they thought up a fresh question of their own to ask him. One of them, a lawyer, spoke up. "Sir, which is the most important commandment in the laws of Moses?" Jesus replied, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. The second most important is similar. Love your neighbor as much as you love yourself." This is the word of the Lord.
Let us now sing our prayer chorus, "We Have Come Into This House." Then Mr. Percy Sands will deliver the pastoral prayer.
Thank you.
All right. It's now time to enjoy our choruses. He has made me glad, and as the dare, and I invite Mr. Barry Newbold to direct us as we do so.
Morning, Ebenezer. I will enter his gates. You've entered them this morning. Let's praise God as we sing. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will enter. You can do better than that. One more time. I will enter his gates. As the deer pants for the water, so my soul longs after you. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship you. As the deer pants for the water, so my soul strength, you alone, you alone may my strength. I want you more than gold and silver. I want Alexis Pinder comes now with a special reading.
Good morning. God is Love by Sally Larkin Green. God listens each time you speak. God helps you find when you begin to seek. God grants you peace when chaos storms your way. God is the light, God is the night, God is the day. God gives you sight to see his grace. God shines his light upon your face. God sends relief from stress and strain. God is faith, God is hope, God will remain. God knows your name, don't be afraid. God speaks to you when you kneel down to pray. God lifts you up each time you fall. God crowns you, God crowns me God crowns us all. God leads you home, he has a plan. He'll fill your heart, he'll hold your hand. God sends you angels from above. God is great, God is good, God is love.
I'm sure you picked up our theme for this morning. Thank you, Alexis. The love God loves us and our love for God. The next hymn, 421, I am so glad that our Father in heaven does what tells of his love in the book he has given. Let us stand as we sing. Tells of his love in the book he has given, wonderful things in the world. This is the day, this is the day. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Though I forget him. Though I forget should ask.
As you have raised us to new lives in Christ, give us love and great generousness, hearts ready to praise you and respond to those in need through Jesus Christ and Savior and Lord. Amen.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, O creatures here below. Praise Him.
Let us prepare ourselves as we open our ears to be blessed by Ms. Kaylee Roberts and Ms. Tegan Thordeson, who will come and offer a musical selection. That was truly a beautiful selection, girls. Come on, guys, we gotta give them one more round of applause for that. We now invite Mr. Alexander Wilkinson, who will come and read our second scripture.
Morning. The second scripture reading is taken from Genesis chapter 22, verses 9 to 12. And they came to the place which God had told them of, and Abraham lived in the land of Moriah, and they went in order and found Isaac his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. And the angel of the Lord called unto him of the heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here I am. And he said, Lay not thy hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him. But now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, from me. Here is the scripture reading.
Let us come together and sing our hymn of faith, hymn number 716, Thou God of Truth and Love, as we open our hearts to receive the word of the day to be given by Ms. Giovanna Knowles.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you that we are able to come here in your name, O God. We thank you for this Youth Sunday where we can see our young people shine. Father God, we ask that the message goes forth according to your will, Almighty God, and allow your Holy Spirit to transcend through this room. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Today my topic is the love language. The love language. As most of us know, February is considered the month of love, especially with its celebration of Valentine's Day. With that in mind, today's New Sunday is all about the love between us and God. Let us also remember that we are in the season of Lent, which is the time we prepare for Easter. During Lent, we focus heavily on how God sent his only son, Jesus Christ, to die so that we are saved from sin and can have life everlasting. God loves us so much that he made a way for us to mend our relationship with him. All of this ties into the beautiful word called love. In the book of Romans 8, 38 to 39, it says, "For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." Scriptures are clear about God's love for us. And to be honest, we often look at Christian love from the perspective of how God feels about us. But if we look at things from the next way round, and God decided to describe the depth of our love for him, what would he be able to say about it? Today, instead of mainly focusing on how much God loves us, I want to look at how much we love God. What are we doing on our end to hold up the relationship and make God feel good about us? In most healthy relationships, people tend to learn the love language of one another so that messages of love can be understood and communicated clearly. For example, it's just an example now. Taking me out on dates every week may not prove to me you love me. But in my world, reading the Bible with me often may be the way that I understand love, so that is my love language. God knows just what to do to show us love. However, what is the language we should be speaking so that God gets the message loud and clear of how much we love him? Today, we will look at what that language is, and I will use the story of Abraham being tested to show how the language is used, how it draws us closer to God, and how it helps us to receive all of the love God offers. I would also like to say the story of Abraham will come under the scripture exam that your Sunday school teachers have you so prepared for, right? And your youth department, right? Y'all ready, right? So pay close attention. I know y'all love this, okay? The language that God understands from us is actually called love, which is to listen, obey, value, and embrace him. I've put this acronym together to help us to remember what the language is, what it includes, and what I will talk about today. So let's look at that word love again, if you remember what I just said. What does the L stand for? Listen. O, obey. V, value. E, embrace. Ooh, y'all gonna do good on y'all exam too. Y'all catch that quick. All right. The degree in which we do these things speaks volumes about how we feel about God. And in many stories, among many biblical heroes, such as Noah, Abraham, David, Daniel, and more, we will find that they all were required to listen, obey, value, and embrace the Lord in order to please him and to move his Holy Spirit. Let us start with the letter L for the word listen. And I want to take a little bit more time on this one than the others, because without listening, it's not far you can get. You can't obey what you don't have. You can't value what you don't get. So we will take time on listening. The general definition of the word listen is to pay attention, to sound, to hear something and use thoughtful attention and consideration upon what is heard. So let's see how Abraham puts this into action. So looking at Genesis 22, the story of Abraham, some of what was read earlier says, when they reached the place God had told him about, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar, on top of the wood. Now here is the backstory on what brought Abraham to these actions. Earlier, God gave him instructions where he said, take your son, your only son whom you love, Isaac, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering on a mountain I will show you. For Abraham to be where he was at this point, it meant that to begin with, he must have listened to God when he spoke. Now answer this for me. Does it feel good to be talking to someone who is not listening to a word you say? No. We cannot form a relationship with someone who does not listen. And when we do not listen to God, we block the relationship. So how can the love develop? How does he know how we feel about him? If we listen. Abraham and God were able to communicate clearly with one another and had a good relationship. And one of the keys here was that Abraham would listen to God. So here we see that Abraham listened. It is not always easy for everyone to understand how to hear and listen to God. And there are some common questions when it comes to the topic of listening to him. How do I listen to God? How does God sound? How can I tell if it is really God talking to me? And does he talk to us directly or through signs? These are questions that I would have asked at one point until I took a look back and I realized how God worked. My mom would tell me many times, I'm talking to God, and I used to stand there sometimes and be like, so how are you hearing him? It's not always easy to understand how it works. But the top three ways to solve some of these concerns are, one, we must make up in our minds that we want to hear the voice of our Heavenly Father. So when he does talk, we will be open to hear him. Some of us shut down the idea that God even talks back before giving it a chance, so we won't hear it. We have to pay attention to the word of God when it is being taught to us, because listening to the word is the start of listening to God. He speaks through his word. Listening to God's word helps us to understand his character and spirit so that we are able to identify when it is he that is communicating with us. Three, seek God by reading the Bible, praying and praising and worshiping him. Through these avenues, we create a healthy space for communication to take place between us and God. Now, let me share a story that could bring all of these things into reality so we understand. When I was 6 years old, playing with my friends at music school, one of those friends came to me and she said, Gia, you're my best friend, you know. I love you a lot, and I see you like a sister. I would like us to be blood sisters. And I'm also saying this because we have to be very careful nowadays, okay? We have to know the word to know how to deal in the world, how to cope, okay? She then said, I am going to prick my finger, and I want you to prick yours. Let's place our fingers together where the prick is so we can exchange and touch blood. That way we would become real sisters. I was 6. So I guess the expectation is I may not know better. And sometimes when the enemy comes at us, he wants to get us when we're young because it's expected that we don't understand. And it sounds so good, sisters. Suddenly in my head, I heard my mom's voice using a famous line when something was not right. I heard the words, that devil is a liar. God used something familiar to me, and through my mom's familiar words, God already started talking because he placed it in my mind, I just heard. Right here, I stopped to think of why this came to my mind.
stopping to consider what came to mind was the start of me listening. And I'm six, so God speaks to us at any time in the way that we get it. Then, because of my family and this very same Sunday school right here, I'm not talking about it because I go here. I can happily brag about this Sunday school and tell you about the foundation right here. I was familiar with some of the stories of God by that age, from the Bible. The Bible is actually God speaking to us as we learn of Him and learn His views on situations. Because the Word was in my heart, I was somehow able to get this feeling of being heartbroken about what she said. In seconds, I felt emotionally strange and disconnected to what she said. This is because her request did not match the Word of God in my heart. That is why we must have the Word in our heart, because that is also how the Lord speaks to us. Once God got my attention, I remember just standing there, stand still, looking at her, and she waiting for me to respond, and I, in another day, is just going through all of this in my head and feeling all of this. And I took time to listen to what God placed in my heart and mind. I created a space for God to say more. And He put the icing on the cake as He revealed Himself clear as day to me. I heard this voice, not Mom's voice, a voice that said these words. At the cross, Jesus already shed blood for you so that you may be reconnected to God. You don't need no bloodshed and an extra connections with nobody. Clear as day. Because I was already in the state of mind to listen. Through the love of Christ, you are sisters without a blood exchange. So simply tell people you're the sisters. It's that simple. God used my simple knowledge of the Bible, my lessons, my mom, and my willingness to help me recognize His voice. The love where He saved me from something dangerous. He saved me because at the time, I did not understand. I would not have understood that those actions are related to the occult. And not only that, you do not exchange blood without medical supervision. But at six, I would not know that, but God knew best. That's why we listened to Him. Now, on to the letter O for obey. Obedience is an act of worship and demonstrates our love for God. It's through obedience that we show God how much we trust Him. This is where we exercise faith. Obedience activates God's power to work in our lives. And this way we experience the fullness of His love. I am going to pick on, I just want to go for much younger. Oh, this is a hard choice. Come, just come. Don't come this way. I just want you to follow some instruction. Raise your right hand. Okay, put it down. So that means right is going which way? That way. Okay, I want you to walk to the right and then stop when I say stop. Go. Stop. Go down the steps carefully and curve around the altar until you see something purple. Look down, sorry, stop, stop, turn around. Oh, where? Oh, there you go. To where? Oh, there we go, that's fine. Walk over this way. Stand right here, stand right there. Do you see anything purple? I need the person who knows where it is to say it. Only Kathleen? Did somebody move something? There was a bag right there. Did anyone move it? Oh, that's what happened. Oh. Okay, so go to where it is. pick it up, put it back. Let's do it again. Go to your right, walk, stop, be careful and turn, curve left, look down, and what do you see? Boy, you saw it a long time. Pick it up. You can take it to your seat. Okay. This was to demonstrate obedience. Obedience is as simple as that. Kathleen would not have said anything. It's not an argument. Just told her where to go, how, and she would find what's supposed to be there. If she had gone the opposite way or done things different and maybe debate with me, we might not have even gotten to the Skittles. Okay? In the story of Abraham, it says, then he reached out his hand and took the knife to slay his son. But the angel of the Lord called out to him from heaven, Abraham, Abraham, do not lay a hand on the boy. Now I know that you fear God because you have not withheld me from your son, your only son. Abraham looked up, and there in the thicket he saw a ram. So God provided a ram to be sacrificed instead. Later on, the angel called to Abraham from heaven a second time and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you and make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and as the sand on the seashores. And your descendants will take possession of the cities of their enemies. And through your offspring, all nations on earth will be blessed because you obeyed me. God is pleased with obedience. And look how obedience puts us in position to receive everything God has for us. Abraham could have said, God, this doesn't sit right with me. This is my child. Why and how? But he did not. And in him listening to God, he got more than he even expected. Sometimes we don't experience the fullness of God because we only obey to the extent that we understand. And when we do that, we only get to the degree that we put in. Some of us cannot vouch for how powerful God is because we've never allowed God to showcase the whole way. And when it comes to obedience, no matter how it looks, because this was a situation, you in a position, listen, if anybody asks me to sacrifice a sari, I don't think that would be easy for me. This is going to be a debate. Okay? And then the next thing I would wonder is, am I really hearing God's voice? That is the purpose of having a relationship with God, because you do need to be able to tell which voice you are listening to. And you need to make an environment where it's only God that will be talking direct to us. The environment we create can bring the wrong voice in as well. So we always need to be at a place of worship and praise. Abraham was given a tough situation, but because of his trust in God, he knew that whatever God was planning to do was going to be well done. And we have to believe God that much, that we are willing to listen and obey even when we are not understanding. Now, we are on the letter V for value. When we love God, we value him and his word. When we value something or someone, it means we place it at high standards. We see it as priority. And as something to treasure and keep sacred and dear to us. Value is seen in the way that we treat others, speak, dress, give, love, forgive, operate in ministries, operate in his kingdom, the way we execute our talents, utilize our lives, and the list goes on. If we value God, we want to represent God the best that we can. Abraham valued God as he valued him, because he valued him enough to put him first. He valued him so much that he came before his son. And his son represents the things that we like so much that we cannot let go of. Sometimes, I mean, I know I could overdo it, but at times I often hear, Gia, you like to be a perfectionist. You will practice over and over and over. And then when it's showtime, you in the back, oh, Lord, help me. All, you know why? Because I value what God places me to do. Everything he gave me, it's not to be done at the lowest standard, and then I go somewhere else and give it a better standard than what I would here in the kingdom. That can't work. I'm going to study the same here as I'm going to study for school. The same way I want to get money on my job, I want to get souls for the kingdom. The work is going to be at the standard, and if I cannot do it, it would be because I could not. Not because I did hardly anything to execute the work of God. Value. And if we feel we cannot do something at value, don't do it at all. E is for embrace. Embrace is to hold someone or something closely in our arms, especially as a sign of affection. It is to willingly and enthusiastically accept a belief, a theory, or a change. When we embrace the Lord, we desire to accept him and his word because we are just so happy to always be so close to him. We don't want any separation. As a matter of fact, to embrace God does not mean we always agree with him or understand or even feel ready to accept certain things. It just means we will just take it for what it is because of the joy to be in the love of God and to please him. Abraham was not excited about killing his son, but he embraced what God said to do because he was enthusiastic about pleasing God. Here is what embrace looks like. Sorry to put you on the spot, Asari, but the day that my daughter was born and the doctors handed her to me, I embraced her. Every aspect of my being embraced her. And I held her close, giving her all the hugs and kisses in the world. As in, I didn't think about what was right or wrong about her, or what I may or may not like, or what the task may be ahead. I just looked at her and took her for what she is, and decided that I would deal with the good and bad and be the best mom I could be. Some of us like to take the word of God and run it through the wires and back just to suit what we want to hear, what we want to do, how we want to support our sins, and everything in the book. All of this before we just accept the word for what it is. Let's just embrace God sometimes with no questions. Even if we are guilty of doing things that God does not approve, it is okay to say, I am struggling with this, but I'm going to believe what my master says and I will work to what he is saying, even if I'm struggling, but don't reject it. Move with God no matter what, because if I waited to get everything right in my life, I would not be here today. God met me struggling, and I'm still struggling, but I am going to embrace because I'm trying to get to the place where God needs me to be. Abraham executed the love language required of us. In that regard, he ended up receiving the full dose of God's love and goodness. God's love for us does not change. It's us who change on God. What is the degree of love we have for God as we celebrate love and Lent? Now, I want to do something that's not on the paper, because you know that thing called listen. I'm glad this worked out this way. I literally hear the voice telling me to let everybody know in here that Kathleen was not trying to remove the Skittles without permission. She misunderstood. I remember now when they looked at me in the candy, I gave them a face because that meant I may pick on any of you and
She believed that to move it out of the way because she is very helpful. The Lord loves me enough to clear it up. And I'm not making that up. Y'all know I'm serious, right? Very serious, okay? So, do we speak the love language to God? Where we listen, obey, value, and embrace Him. Let's say that again. What is L for? Listen. O? Value. Sorry, V, value. And E? Embrace. Let's practice doing that so that our love to God is understood and communicated. Clear. That's fine? Okay, let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for your love. You are all about love. We thank you for loving us so much that you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to die for our sins so that we could be mended back to you. You came looking for us even when we didn't deserve it. Sometimes we don't even look your way and you do not give up on us. Father God, we want our love to be pleasing to you. We want you to be able to look at us and describe our love with beautiful words and bring us to that point and that closeness with you, O God. Father, during the season of Lent, allow us to reflect, but according to your direction. Bring us closer and closer to you, O God. We are just asking for stronger and stronger relationships with you. We are asking you to speak to our nations clear as day, especially our churches that have to lead your way, O God. Father God, we just ask you to place your Holy Spirit upon us. Work through us, O God. Dispatch your angels with us and cover us with the mighty blood of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I believe next we are supposed to say the affirmation. We can do that and write, as we said, I would just like the young people to come up as we say the affirmation. All right, let us start. I believe in God, Father, Almighty Creator, of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified and died in the Spirit. He descended into heaven. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. All right. It's okay I'll have everyone put their hands forth and pray, but let me say this. I wanted to bring them up especially, yes, to pray, but to say that most of them will be doing their scripture exam on Sunday coming. And I just want everyone to know that our young people not only listen, they obey. And can I tell you that they value everything they've been working towards? They embraced it when they were told about the scripture exam. I don't know if they changed their mind behind my back, but I could tell you in my face and the attitude I saw that no one complained. They looked ready, and the answer was, yes, we got this. Do you know how proud the Holy Spirit is of you all? You didn't even have to be here. You could have chose to be somewhere else. In the midst of your exams and your schoolwork, you could have said, I don't want to study this because I don't know about, this isn't working to something I could get paid for, my A grade, but guess what? You all are smart enough to know there is something that is paying for. Just paying for your kingdom space. And I want to say that the Sunday school, the youth department, and everybody is proud of you all who have been ready and studying. And although we like to win, y'all know how we go. It does not matter what you
It does matter, but you know what I mean. It does not matter what you come out with, because we already see that y'all are going in that exam with full effort. And the only thing left after that, whatever grades you get, only tells you how much we'll continue to improve. But the Holy Spirit, your Father, is proud of you. Okay? So let's just pray about the exam and just for all of our young people. And you can feel free to stretch your hand forth or pray quietly, whatever suits our audience. Feel free. And if any Sunday school teachers want to come up, feel free. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for our amazing young people. We thank you, Father God, for their willingness, and we're asking you to give them a great blessing for their awesome attitude towards your word, towards your work. We thank you for the great love they are showing to you right now at an early age, Father. We come against the plan of the enemy to destroy their mindset. That is all for you, oh God. Keep their mind in the right place. Give them the mind of Jesus Christ in all that they do. Father God, if only we could feel how happy the Holy Spirit is right now for that beautiful, positive energy each of you have given, oh God. We thank you. Oh, we thank you. Father, we ask you to go with each of them in that exam next week. Open their minds, their hearts, their memory, and allow them to do as best as they can be. But not for themselves, but for your glory, oh God. Father, the teaching is not about a competition, but it is about learning about you, Father. Do not let the enemy snatch their information and their understanding of who they are in you, oh God. As they learn of you, they learn about themselves. They learn about real love for you, and then they learn about love for themselves. And this is the type of love that the enemy cannot take away and the world will not change. We speak a great blessing on these children, that they will grow and live long in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We come against death. We come against premature death. We come against sickness and anything that is meant to reverse every plan you have for them, oh God. Because we are seeing too many young people be cut down. And these children from this age are working to your kingdom. So innocent. And the enemy wants to snatch that away. But we hold our children close. We value what we do here at church. We thank you for every leader, every parent that has been supportive. Anyone can say what they want, but one thing I can say, that our leaders have been on it to make sure our children learn. Bless them for it. Bless this church for supporting these children. Continue to guide us and give us knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Let them grow to save souls. And if any of them should slip to the side, Father, give us the heart, the wisdom, the knowledge, the understanding to know how to pick them up, bring them in your kingdom, and restore them through you, Jesus Christ. Don't let any of them ever feel ashamed to come to church, no matter what they're going through, or speak to us. Give us the gifts that we need in order to reach them wherever they go. But we ask in you, Lord, that you keep them near you, under your blood. We don't want to hear any bad news about them. We only want to hear the good news. Oh, Father God, and whatever happens in their life, we trust you with it. We turn their lives over to you, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, cover them. Cover us with the blood of Jesus Christ. Dispatch your angels with us every way we go. Cover us with your anointing, oh God. Build this church. Yes, we might have some problems, but that's what families go through. Let us work through everything and continue to build this church, because we have a beautiful foundation. You're the foundation here has brought people up like me and so many who love the Lord today, despite what we've all been through and done in our lives. We come back to the word because this is the foundation where we learn the word. No matter where I go, this place is not about hype, but it is about substance. And one thing we learn here is the full word in our hymns, in our songs, in our teachings. And I appreciate my church family. And Father God, allow all churches to come together and continue to do these great works for their kingdom. Because everyone working for you is important. Everybody matters, oh God. Let us make that impact in this nation. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Wow. That's all I could say. Honestly, God is using you, and He knows why. He knows why. That was amazing. Wow. Sorry. Well, it's that time where our service comes to an end, and as we do so, we will sing our closing hymn, Trust and Obey, hymn number 516. Let us repeat the mission statement together. To worship God joyfully, offer Christ faithfully, promote growth hopefully, serve others lovingly.